Okay, so Chad, this is what we did. We compiled the list of the most famous gangster movies ever made. We have a tier list, and along with the tier list, we have a trailer. We have a trailer for every movie, so in case you haven't seen it or you just want to get reminded, whatever, we're going to see that. Watch the trailer. The original trailer, some of these movies are from the 80s, 90s, 2000, whatever.
Some of them are from the 80s. Oh, wait a minute, excuse me. Wait a minute, what is 80? Good. Some of them are from the 70s.
Godfather, yeah.
Yeah.
And then we're going to rate them just how me and Jake would try a food, and then we would rate them. We're going to do the same thing, but with these movies.
And let me make a comment about this. There are going to be some of you out there that are going to be like, oh, you're missing this or you're missing that. And I would be in agreement. I looked at the list and I'm like, listen, what we did is we looked at, obviously, iconic gangster movies, but we also looked at movies that had a level of popularity. And we could not possibly put 100 movies. Like, it's going to be insane. What I would tell you is,
I don't think we're missing any.
No.
Anything.
I would say any. Now, listen, is there some obscure kind of like, yeah, this is a cool thing that like it's like a cult movie or. Yeah. Like, of course, we can't do that. So what we did is we went by, number one, the most popular gangster movies. We also went to ones that, you know, that did really well as far as like people watching them and seeing them. I think we did a pretty good job. And I will say it again.
Yeah, we're not, listen, we're not missing anything important, okay? There might be something that we forgot about or I forgot about. If we forgot about it, then it's probably not one of the best gangster movies.
Now again, someone out there might disagree and say, oh, how did you miss this movie? It's amazing. It probably is an amazing movie. But we had to make some decisions. The group of movies that you're thinking right now, hey, are we going to see this? Are we going to see that? I could tell you right now, the answer is yes, you're going to see it.
Best gangster movies ever to your list. We got A Bronx Tale, Casino, American Me, Black Mass, Boys in the Hood, Bugsy, American Gangster, Colors, Reservoir Dogs, Donnie Brasco, Pulp Fiction, Gangs of New York, Goodfellas, Carlito's Way, The Departed. There's two Gotti movies.
Two Gotti movies. We're going to explain that.
Heat, The Many Saints of Newark, History of Violence, Scarface, King of New York, Get Shorty, all the Godfather movies, The Irishman, Miller's Crossing, Shot Caller, New Jack City, Once Upon a Time in America, Road to
Perdition,
Perdition, Eastern Promises, Rock and Roll, Untouchables. There's a couple in here that I've only seen like once or maybe I don't even remember them. Someone said, where the fuck is Nemo? All
right, that's funny.
So we're gonna go through these and we're gonna rate them. We're gonna put them in where we think they belong. Okay, first movie on the list, best gangster movies ever, is A Bronx Tale. Let's see.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, I know. Stay in school, get two educations. I know.
That's right. This is my life, not yours. This is not for you. No guns.
I first met Sonny in 1960. I was 9 years old. He was the number one man in the neighborhood. And as I grew, he grew in power. He became a boss. And I was his friend. I wonder why.
I don't care. In a world called the Bronx.
Look, I'm your father. I love you. You're breaking my heart.
Sonny, trust me.
That man can never trust anybody. The sooner you know that, the better.
He was caught in a tug of war between his hardworking father.
I tell your son to go to school, to go to college.
You don't understand. It's not what you say. It's what he sees. It's the clothes, it's the cars, it's the money.
I treat that kid like he's my son.
He ain't your son. He's my son.
And the man who owned the neighborhood.
Don't you trust anybody?
No.
It's a horrible way to live.
For me, it's the only way.
Is it better to be loved or feared?
I would rather be feared. Because fear lasts longer than love.
What was I gonna do, run away? Make people think I got no heart?
I mean, what makes you think you're so special? He'll hurt you like anybody.
Sometimes hurting somebody ain't the answer.
I know who you are, Sonny, and I know what you could do. This time you're wrong. You don't fool a man's family.
So what are you gonna do, fight this?
Stay away from my son!
Robert De Niro, Chaz Palminteri.
You worry about yourself, your family, and the people that are close to you. That's what it comes down to.
A Bronx Tale.
What are your thoughts?
This is tough. That's one of my favorite quote unquote gangster movies. And I don't want to look too far ahead, but that is one of my favorite. That is one of my favorites. But
Are you comfortable? Are you comfortable with an S for Bronx Tale?
I want to give it an A though. I think it's an A.
Yeah. See,
but I can't go S with it. Knowing what else is on his list, I cannot go S. All
right. I think what we don't want to do. Mm-hmm. Here's what we don't want to do.
Yeah.
We don't want to worry about, oh, is there going to be too many S's, not enough A's?
I'm not worried about there's going to be too many S's.
I'm saying in your heart, when you're thinking of gangster movie, a phenomenal gangster movie, dude, Bronx Tale is in your discussion as your one of your favorite gangster movies. I will tell you this much.
I don't know. I think it's an A.
Okay. When you talk about iconic gangster movies. And then you talk about, you know, really good gangster movies.
Yeah, this is...
I'm going to...
Dude, A is really good.
I'm going to say... And listen, I love A Bronx Tale. I mean, I love it. But I also respect... I also respect the S tier. I respect it.
It's reserved for...
I'm going to concur A Bronx Tale is an A.
It's an A. It's an A.
I'm going to concur.
It is great. But it's when great. We're talking about S, we are talking about the best.
I know, but don't mention other names. Don't mention other names.
All right, next up, Casino.
I was a hell of a handicapper, I can tell you that. I had it down so good that I ran paradise on earth. I had one of the biggest casinos in Las Vegas to run for Tangiers. You know, if I did it, I'd have to run it my way.
Nobody's gonna interfere with you running the casino, I guarantee it. Nicky,
you're a guy. Make a lot of money for us, so keep a good eye on it.
All right. Look at this place, it's made of money. What do you think about me moving out here?
I just gotta tell you, it's no joke out here.
One of the things I never liked about this movie was how he talked in this movie.
Oh.
Joe Pesci. Every other movie, he never sounds like this.
Well, because he's from the Midwest.
He's doing some weird voice in this.
No, it's a Midwest. It's a Midwest. He's not like
an East Coast guy.
No, he's a Midwest. That's why he has that funny, yeah.
He's got a weird... Anyone who's seen this knows what I'm talking about. Even in Home Alone, he didn't sound like this.
Because he's from the Midwest. That's why.
Yeah.
Me moving out here.
I just gotta tell you, it's no joke out here. You gotta keep a low profile. Right off the bat, they don't like guys like us. Oh,
yeah! Oh. Amazing scene.
Dude, just
amazing
on.
Scene.
Just right play here. I just play a trailer.
You like your money a lot. Yes, don't you?
Well, how about that?
Yeah.
I want to settle down. I want a family.
You got the wrong girl.
You'll be set up for the rest of your life.
You don't know me. What do you know me? 2-3 months.
They had it all. They ran the show. And it was paradise. While it lasted.
Crazy!
They found a guy's head in the desert. That's no good.
We got a problem.
He doesn't listen to me. Maybe he should get lost for a while. Take a vacation.
Can't make it any clearer, Sam. I would just get out.
I try to do everything for you, even though I knew deep down inside you would bury me.
I buried you. You buried yourself.
I have to be able to trust you with my life.
Can I trust you? Can I trust you?
You want me to get out of my own town? You only exist out here because of me.
He's a loose cannon.
No! Stop it!
You realize what you can do? You can get us all killed!
You want to get rid of me?
They're showing a lot in this trailer.
Get rid of me.
What the fuck? They showed like a whole movie.
I'm gonna tell you.
There's not much I need to say about this one. So go ahead.
I'm gonna tell you something. When this movie came out, right before it came out, I was in New York with a bunch of guys after work, and we were going out to a bar. It's when I worked in the city, and one of the guys said, "Oh, because remember this was after Goodfellas." He goes, "Yeah, Scorsese's got another movie with De Niro and Pesci. It's called Casino. Blah 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 blah." And we were talking about it, you know. I remember going to see it and being like, I actually had to watch it twice.
You were probably disappointed the first time.
No, I just was. I wouldn't say disappointed. I just was like, I need to see it twice. So when I think of Casino, first of all, I don't know if you know, like, there's some really funny shit in Casino. There's some funny shit in Casino. Like, it's not supposed to be funny, but it is. Like, you know. So I love Casino. To me, Casino's an A. It's not an S. And that's my take on it. I love Casino. I'm saying A. Are you okay? Now I want to hear your take. Go ahead.
See, I have this movie above A Bronx Tale.
Yeah.
So okay, if I'm going off of us having Bronx Tale A, yeah, then in my head I'm like, okay, this is a level above. It's S. If you're saying it's an A, it's not an S movie.
No, but no,
I would move Bronx Tale right now.
Okay, first of all, A Bronx Tale is an A. It's a solid A. Now,
if Casino was on TV and Bronx Tale was on TV, Bronx Tale, I'll watch it sometimes. Casino, I'm just going to watch the movie.
That doesn't necessarily mean that it has to be in another tier. It could just mean that you have two A's and you prefer one over the other. Remember something. The way it was explained to me, the way you just explained to me, I'm putting S at another level. I love Casino. I love A Bronx Tale, and I'm very comfortable with Casino as a solid A. I'm flirting with S.
I'm good with high A for Casino.
Yes, yes.
I'm good with that.
Yes,
I'm good with that.
Now we're moving on to American Me. This came out 30 years ago, right? If I'm not mistaken, 1992. If I'm not mistaken.
Mm-hmm.
It was right around the time I was getting married, and I was with my cousin, and he's like, "Have you seen this movie?" And I'm like, "No." He goes, "It's fucking sick."
Mm-hmm.
I've probably seen this movie 10 times. It's pretty amazing.
One is like a kid, the other one.
The way it has always been. From father to son.
Something we've ever had.
From brother to brother.
No, mundo todo, man!
He ruled a world we do not know.
Italians are still running the show, but they're getting sloppy, man.
You'll regret today you make.
Well, your business kills kids, man.
You know, sometimes your whole life can change from being in the wrong place at the wrong time.
You push your weakness now, Holmes. Everybody's gonna see it.
Like, fake it, just take it.
You got a lot of heart, Carmen. Maybe too much.
From director Edward James Olmos, inspired by a true story, American Me.
I know that you did see this. It was probably a long time ago.
I mean,
I could kind of give you my take on it a little bit, but
we're gonna have to go off your take, because I vaguely remember this is like an old movie.
Yeah, I love this movie. It's set. It's obviously it's prison. It's you have the Mexican gangs, and then you have their interaction with the Italian mafia. In this genre, I like this as a B. I think it's a solid B.
A B?
I like it as a B. I like it as a B. I wouldn't see. Here's the thing. To me, like, C is just like kind of. It's kind of like just an okay. Like, this movie was very powerful. I would say.
So you're saying this is a better than like an okay movie.
Yeah, oh, much very much all so. Right,
then we'll put
very
it B.
much so.
Because I have nothing to go off on this one.
You get a sense of what I'm talking about here.
Next,
this is oh my God, dude.
Johnny Depp.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Black Mass.
This thing was Oh my God. This shit was off the hook. Oh my God, was this amazing.
I need to know everything you know about the Winter Hill Gang, and specifically what you know about your former boss and now fugitive, James Whitey Bulger.
What's that?
Oh.
In the beginning, Jim was a small town player. He's a very smart, disciplined man.
Take your shot, but make it your best. Because I get up, I eat you. I'm at
the
table,
you can come and let you. And the next thing you know, he's a damn kingpin. You know why? Because the FBI let it happen.
I grew up with Jimmy and his brother Billy, the senator, and that is
a bond. Oh my God, dude, wait, this is so fucking good.
This is very dark waters. Jimmy's business is Jimmy's business.
This is a good ass fucking
movie. Oh my God, this is fantastic.
Even you. I can help you, Jimmy, and you can help me. It's an alliance. Get the FBI to fight our wars, and we do whatever we want to do. The success just getting started. Till it's
gone. Boom! Jump to the sky for
my people. I walk through the fire. Just playing this. Make a fool of the Bureau. Tell
me we're in too deep. And he knows it. Come around me telling
me I changed. God help us.
How come no one has nailed Whitey Bulger? He seems to be involved in every crime in the city, and yet the Bureau keeps saying he's clean.
Well, what's Bulger done?
What's he done? Everything. I'm at the
trash can, at the last man, at the finish line now. You cannot say that to me. Just follow and push around. I'm not changing jobs. In the haystack that you finally found. This ain't no free
rent. Come on, bitch, you tip me and tie me down. If he gives me his word, he will keep it. Oh,
oh, till it's gone. Oh, oh, okay. Damn.
Go ahead. I want to hear your comments.
First of all, I haven't seen that in a couple years.
Yeah.
The cast in that movie is really good.
Oh my God. Are you kidding me? Phenomenal.
Really fucking
phenomenal,
good.
Dude. Phenomenal.
My initial first thoughts were this is like a high B, low A to me. That's my thoughts.
I couldn't agree more.
Yeah. D, dude, you haven't. All right, if right, you're right, saying right. D, you not, didn't see this movie, bro.
First of all, here's the thing.
D is a bad movie.
First of all, it's a true story. He was an informant for the FBI. Hello? I'm very comfortable with a B.
But top of B right now.
Better than American Me, yes. Yes, yes. A top B.
Good.
I'm not putting it with Casino and Bronx Tale. I'm not doing that. I'm not. But this movie, Black Mass, I fucking love this movie. Johnny Depp. You didn't even know you were watching Johnny Depp? That's how crazy this was.
I know.
I love this movie.
Let's see what chat thinks. Chat has 50% B. Wow.
Mm-hmm. I'm going to tell you right now, I don't think we're going to be way off with many of these. I don't think so. I don't think so. Go ahead.
All right, next is a classic movie.
It's a classic. It is. No, this is legitimately a classic. It legitimately is.
I would say most of these movies, we're going to say that.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
No, but Boys in the Hood is a legitimate classic. Yeah.
This is a legitimately classic.
Yeah. Yeah.
This is Los Angeles, gang capital of the nation.
Just goes on and on, you know. Either they don't know, don't show.
Fucking great movie,
don't
man.
Don't care about
God
what's
damn.
Going on in the hood.
South Central LA.
Yo, Benito, let's do the local thing.
It's tough to beat the streets.
What am I supposed to do? Fool roll up, try to smoke me? I'm gonna shoot the motherfucker.
You have to think, young brother, about your future.
Man, why are you sweating?
You're my only son, and I'm not gonna lose you to no bull.
Don't worry about it. I can take care of
yourself. Bro, that's a crazy.
Wanted to work his way up.
Did you see that?
Trey is a grown man now. He is not a little boy anymore.
Oh, my God. Like this is so good, man.
Move, man.
Maybe some of what you got to rub off on him.
Ricky was looking for a better life.
I want to do something with my life, all right? I want to be somebody.
When you were a little boy, you used to run around here all the time with that
fucking heartbreaking, man.
Heartbreaking. I always knew you would amount to something.
Ugh.
Doughboy was living by the laws of the street.
Fuck you looking at, nigga? We got a problem here? We got a problem, nigga?
Can we have one night where there ain't no fight and nobody gets shot?
It's hard to be a saint in South Central L.A.
I don't understand why you insist on learning things the hard way, Trey, but you gonna learn.
How to survive in South Central, rule number one. Get yourself a gun, and then South Central game. That's how you survive. Rule number two, don't trust nobody, especially a girl with a hooker's body. Rule number three, don't take your life for granted. This is the craziest place on the planet.
Something wrong? Something wrong, yeah. It's just too bad you don't know what it is.
Yo, gonna lift my hat, tilt to the back, and strap with it, getting ready to count.
Hey, yo, Q, watch out, mother.
Jesus Christ!
I mean, okay, first of all, so I've seen this movie, obviously, many times, and my first reaction when I see this movie and I watch that trailer again, to me, it's an A. I gotta put it in an A. I look at Black Mass and American Me, and I'm like, I love those movies, but this is better. There's something about Boys in the Hood, like, I think it's kind of an iconic movie, to be honest with you. I
like, it almost seems so iconic that, like, I feel like it has to be. If we're looking at all these movies, there's only a few that are, like, iconic, like, the cover, like, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, dude, half of these are not iconic, like, you know, known movies.
Dude, are you saying to me right now, are we sort of agreeing it's an S?
I'm not saying where on the S, but I feel like it has to be
I'm gonna tell you
S.
Right now. Okay. Dude, I'm telling you right now, I'm okay with an S. I really am. I love that movie. I mean, it's tragic. And I think it's one of, like, it really gave you, like, dude, that was authentic. Like, it felt like it was, you know how you watch some of these movies and you don't buy it? Like, I don't buy it. Like, that movie, like, that was extremely real. It was tragic. I'm going to tell you.
But now I'm thinking about Casino. Because I have it above Bronxdale. But now I'm thinking about Casino.
So why don't we do this then? I would be.
Are we sure Casino's not an S? Are we sure Casino isn't a fucking S? A Martin Scorsese movie, Robert De Niro, that's not an S? Are we sure about this?
I'm gonna go back on what I said. I think Boys in the Hood is an A and Casino's an S.
Wait, now you're.
No, I'm allowed to.
Go ahead. What's your? Yeah.
No, because you just made a great point. You're saying, first of all, everybody's in agreement. Everybody knows Boys in the Hood. I mean, I'm not really, like, that was, that's a powerful fucking movie. But then now that you laid it out, you're like, Casino, like Scorsese, De Niro, you know what? I gotta go Casino S and Boys in the Hood A.
My thing is, I want them on the same category.
Are you in agreement with me?
I want them in the same category.
I can't, oh my God.
Because you first said A, so I was like, oh, Boys in the Hood and Casino. Okay, I want them in the same category.
Dude, you know what? I'm gonna say this right now to you.
But then wait a second. No, it's an A.
It's
an A, and I'm actually down.
No, I'm comfortable. I'm comfortable with an A.
Tell me if this looks bad to you.
Yeah.
Tell me if this looks bad to you.
Never. No way. No way.
Tell me if this looks bad to you.
No way. No. You're not. There's no way in hell a Bronx Tale's a B. I was flirting with an S. Don't do that. There's no way, bro. There's no way. Bronx Tale? What? Are you kidding me?
Let's just leave it.
You know what? I'm okay with that.
Let's just leave it.
I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that.
I just, guys, knowing what's on this list, dude, S is too sacred, bro.
S is too sacred. Wait, do you understand what an A, how
I good can't,
an
dude,
A
I can't,
is?
I can't.
Wait.
And I love Casino.
Wait a minute, do you understand?
I love Bronx Tale. I love Boys in the Hood.
Do you understand how good A is? This is top of the heap.
All right, let's go.
Are you serious?
No, because they're... Listen, Listen. They're going to disagree. They're going to agree. We can't focus on the job. We got to do our list.
A is fantastic. What the fuck?
That's fine. All right, next up. This is one of my
all-time. I love this movie. It's crazy. It's funny. Can I just say something before we start the trailer?
Go ahead.
Guys, a lot of you maybe have not seen this movie, Bugsy. Warren Beatty, Annette Bening. It's the story of Bugsy Siegel. So Bugsy Siegel was part of, they were Jewish gangsters in New York. They grew up as young kids together. And Bugsy Siegel was actually credited with starting Las Vegas. He actually went out there and it was his concept, his idea.
Yeah.
Okay. He did such a good job. And it's kind of goofy and fun. It's, you know, I mean, obviously he's a psychopath, but it's kind of a cool movie. There's a lot of funny stuff in it. I love this movie. I love it. So let's go.
This is from 91. This is going to be a bad trailer. I can already tell.
Hollywood has always been fascinated by gangsters. In 1943, a gangster became fascinated with Hollywood.
Just had this suit pressed. Take your paws off it.
So one guy came in here and robbed five guys of $56,000 in their own place of business and got away scot-free.
The rest of the time, you're just another good-looking, sweet-talking, charm-oozing fella with nothing to offer but some dialogue. Why don't you run outside and jerk yourself a soda?
I don't like how they do trailers, bro. Like, all these old-ass trailers, this is weird.
But you have to understand something, though.
But this isn't like the movie, though. This movie is,
but I'm saying this movie's from the 40s. So the way they talk, the way, you know, the way they act with the dread, the way they dread, this is from the 40s. So it's, you know, it's based on, it's a true story, but it's based on, you know, this is a long, long time ago.
Who are you referring to? Prenum fruitcake?
If I were you, I would get that money back by 7 o'clock tonight.
Okay, I do want to, someone said something and I want to address this. Someone said, do clips of the movies, not trailers. That was what originally was going to happen. But most of the clips can't be shown on Twitch.
No.
These are R-rated movies you can't see them.
No, we're going. We're going to show you the trailer, and then we're going to kind of give you an opinion. Now, listen, some of these movies I've seen lots of times. Some of these movies we've seen. Some movies he hasn't seen, you know, or as much. I know you've at least, I think you've seen all of them. Maybe there's a handful you haven't, but I'm just saying generally. All right, let's go.
Famous isn't good, Ben. For Clark Gable, it's good. For Joe DiMaggio, it's good. Famous for you, it's not good.
Ben! He's my brother!
Did you think you could steal from me? From Maya Lansky and Charlie Luciano and get away with it?
You are going to kill Mussolini personally in the middle of a war?
Ben, I don't understand this desert thing of yours. What are we, Bedouins?
What are you talking about here? A whole house?
I'm talking about a hotel. I'm talking about a place where gambling is allowed.
To our destiny, Las Vegas.
A hotel in the middle of the Mojave Desert, 500 miles away from the nearest toilet bowl.
Truth is, he's not even interested in money for himself off this deal. He's interested in the idea.
What idea?
Building something, making something. Ben, he's a dreamer.
Blow my head off! Do it! Do it!
What fantasy have you concocted in your sick mind?
I believe he was blinded by love. Benny's always put women first. That's what makes him Benny. Only this time it's one woman that's got him instead of the whole damn female race.
I'm sure you're right about the things that you want to get.
Do you always talk this much before you do it?
I only talk this much before I'm going to kill someone.
Okay.
That's,
So I can tell you, I'm like, for me, I it really is a fantastic movie. It's a period piece, true story. I like a C on this one.
I was gonna say C. This
it's
is
a
the most
very good.
This guys, is the most middle.
Guys, I'm telling you
of the.
I'm
road.
Honestly telling you though, if you can remember,
and that trailer was
if
ass.
You could remember, well, it's an old trailer. If you can remember to check it out, it's called Bugsy. It's actually a very it tells you to, it's like. It goes really to the history of Vegas. Somebody created Vegas, And it was a gangster. So it's pretty cool. Anyway. Yeah. Anyway. All right. Oh. Oh.
Oh.
Oh. One of my favorites. Oh, my God. Here we go.
One of my favorites. Next up, American Gangster.
Oh.
The man I worked for had one of the biggest companies in New York City. He didn't own his own company. White man owned it, so they owned him. Nobody owns me, though. Most important thing in business is honesty.
Bribery. Extortion.
Integrity, hard work.
Murder, racketeering.
Family. Never forgetting where we came from.
Who is this guy?
See, you are what you are in this world. That's either one of two things.
Dude.
Either you're somebody.
Dude, come on, man.
Or you ain't nobody.
Whose house is that, Frank?
That is your house, mama.
Mine!
Want what you got, Uncle Frank? I want to be you. My investigation indicates that Frank Lucas is above the mafia. Who does he work for? Which family? He's not Italian, he's black.
No black man has accomplished what the American mafia hasn't in 100 years.
They tried to kill my wife.
Frank Lucas is the most dangerous man walking the streets of our city.
This is my home. My country. Frank Lucas don't run from nobody. This is America.
I have a very, very strong feeling about this movie.
Again, this is our favorite movies. So, like, this isn't, maybe it's not going to be the most critically acclaimed that are an S and A and whatever. American Gangster, that's a fucking S to me.
Oh, it's an S.
That's a fucking S.
Oh, that's
S.
A fucking S.
Okay. Okay.
As a matter of fact,
we're on the same page.
As a matter of fact,
yeah.
As a matter of fact, I'm going to watch it tomorrow.
I want to watch this now.
Now I'm going to watch
it. This,
you know, it's a true story, too, which is,
that's what makes it,
which
better.
Is crazy. Which is crazy. First of all,
this is over Casino.
Oh,
this
yeah.
This is over Casino.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. No, it's over. Yeah. So now, hold it. Let me just say this. By the way, this is fun as fuck, by the way. I'm really enjoying this. That American Gangster is such a good movie. Like, it's an epic movie. I mean, Denzel killed it. It was just... If you haven't seen it, you got to check it out, man. Just absolutely fucking amazing. Oh, I'm so glad we agreed on that, because that was just
Yeah. Listen, anyone in here who hasn't seen this movie, because maybe there's younger people or you know whatever who haven't seen any of these movies so far, please watch at least watch the movies we're rating S and A. That's all I'm saying, because I know people haven't watched every single movie. If it's an S and A, I guarantee you it won't waste your time.
So let me just say
next
this.
Movie, what are
I
we
can
on?
Guarantee you this movie is from the 80s. It's called Colors. Similar with respect to the setting, South Central, young cop, old cop, and how they're dealing with the gangbangers and everything.
They're
gangbangers. That's what they call them. What do you mean? And the gangbanger. That's what those guys are. I'm not talking about a porno, you weirdo.
That's
what they call them. That's what they would call them. They would deal with these guys. Sean Penn and Robert Duvall, tremendous in this movie. It's really, really good. I'm gonna tell you, I don't think this is one that you've seen. I don't think this maybe
this one and one other one I've never seen.
Okay, but then I'm just gonna kind of let's do the trailer and talk about it. So let's go. This is crazy.
Hey, blood.
The gangs rule the streets. The streets are at war. The war must be stopped.
We want a uniform presence out in the street. They're flying their colors. We're flying ours.
If I
do something, I expect you to back me
Dude,
up.
I think I've seen this.
Yeah.
I think I've seen this.
I know you have. I know you have. I thought so. But I
You
I
get
just...
them off the street.
Lady, we're trying.
Our community have kids out there.
I don't
there.
Like
we're
remember.
Dying I mean, actually dying over red or blue.
How old are you?
18.
How old are you?
14.
Gavin.
You ever go out with a cop?
You don't like cops, do you?
No.
But you're just like them, Pac-Man. Nothing but a gangster.
It's always gonna be gangs, man. There's always gonna be fighting.
You can stop it for yourselves, man.
I'm getting huge 80s Robert vibes Duvall. In this trailer.
Oh, big time.
In a Dennis Hopper film, Colors.
Okay.
So, really good piece. I'm not going to put it, I'm not putting it with Black Mass and American Me, though. Yeah, I'm going C on this one.
Again.
Very good. It's very good, though. Very good. You got to check it out. It's very good. It's very good.
Quentin Tarantino's first movie.
1992.
Reservoir Dogs.
Reservoir Dogs. Yeah. Saw it in the movies. Saw it in the movies and really enjoyed it.
Put the gun down!
Why am I Mr. Pink?
Yeah, that's easy for you to say. You're Mr. White. Cool sounding name.
Got a white.
Well, I don't know why I came here tonight. I got the feeling there's something right.
Cut off one of his fingers.
I'm so scared in case I fall off the chair.
If they hadn't done what I told them not to do, they'd still be alive.
You're acting like a first-year thief. I'm acting like a professional.
Choice we've been doing 10 years. Taking out some stupid motherfuckers. Ain't no choice at all.
Bam.
Bam. Bam, 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 bam.
You're under arrest, sugar.
Harvey Keitel, Chris Penn, Steve Buscemi, Lawrence Tierney, and Michael Madsen, the Reservoir Dogs.
Hey, Joe, I'm gonna shoot this guy.
You could start. Go ahead.
Initial thoughts are, I love Quentin Tarantino's movies. This is his first movie. I have it top of B, lower A.
This movie, I'm in agreement with you. I would say that this is it's a low A. I'm not comfortable saying B because I mean it's a really, really good movie. I like Reservoir Dogs better than Black Mass and American Me, but I also think that it's in a conversation when you look at Casino, you look at Boys in the Hood, you look at A Bronx Tale. I'm comfortable saying low A, but putting it in an A category. I'm not comfortable with B because it's an iconic movie. It really is.
Yeah, I said low
That's
A.
That's good. I think we're right in the line here, so it's good. Oh my God, one of my oh yeah. One of my favorites.
All right, next
one
up.
One of my favorites.
Donnie Brasco from the year 1997.
Mm-hmm. 25th anniversary.
I was 2 years old.
25th. I read the book, by the way. I read this book. Fantastic.
When I introduce you, I'm going to say, this is a friend of mine. That means you're connected, gang.
Full gaze.
Now, if
Full
I gaze. Said, this is a friend of ours, that would mean you were made, gang. A capiche?
When Lefty brought Donnie into his world.
Who's this guy? This is Donnie, a friend of mine.
He took a risk on a kid he hardly knew.
I'm gonna have to school you, my friend.
School me in what?
Why this guy never carries his money in a wallet? Always in a roll. Beaner, on the outside.
He gave him his trust.
You gotta get rid of that Mustang. Get yourself a pair of pants. Trust.
He loved him like a son.
Nobody can touch you because I represent you. Your nose clean, follow the rules. Maybe one day when they open the books, you could come a wise guy. I'd die with you, Donnie.
But he never knew the truth.
There's a war going on in that mafia family, and that is where Joe is under.
Come here!
I want to know where my husband is.
We don't know.
You're going to freeze up? No. A lot of guys freeze up.
You said it was going to be 3 months. It's going on 3 years.
Who he's with and who he's close to, they're all the top dogs now. He's right in the line of fire.
There was a rat in Florida, Donnie. You know what to do when you find that rat, right, Left? Could be I found him already.
In our thing, you get sent for, go in alive, you come out dead, and it's your best friend that does it.
You have got to pull him out. You think I'm a rat?
How many times I have you into my own house? If you're a rat, then I'm the biggest mutt in the history.
If I come out, Lefty dies. They're gonna kill him. Because he vouched for him. Because he stood up for him. That's the same thing as if I put a bullet in his head myself. Do you understand?
Who am I? I'm a spoke. Let's take a walk. I'm your best friend.
Go ahead. What's your thought? Just throw it out there. Don't...
I say this is the most solid A we can have. Mm-hmm. I think just middle A, it's just solid A.
I would agree with you. If you said B, I would be okay with that.
I was gonna say B.
I love the movie, but I do have some problems with the movie too.
Like the ending?
Well, I know how it ends because I read the book. And I think for me, part of the problem is I read the book. Some of the characters were like a little too cartoon, or a little like a cartoonish like character. I didn't buy it. Like these guys, like let me tell you something. I read the book. All these dudes in this movie were fucking hardcore. Like I meant the characters. Like in real life, those guys, they were hardcore. I had a problem buying it, but I'm okay with an A. But if we said B, I'd be okay with that too.
I'm trying to think if it's more on the level of Black Mass or Bronx Tale.
I think it's more on a level with Black Mass than Bronx Tale. I know it's crazy. Like you think I should be saying Donnie Brasco's an automatic A. I think in all fairness, it's a high B. I would put it higher than Black Mass, but am I putting it with Casino and Bronx Tale? I'm not doing that. And maybe it's because I read the book. I don't know what your thoughts are. If you want to put low A, but I'm saying high B. I'm saying like in front of Black Mass. That's just my take on it.
This one was on this is like a fringe gangster movie. They are gangsters.
Yeah, we had to put it in.
And it's such they an work for and it's, a gangster.
And it's such an iconic movie. And let me just say this. I want to just add this. It's in my top 10 all-time movie. Like if you said write down 10 movies, it's in my top 10. It's one of my favorites of all time.
Miramax Films is proud to present one of the most celebrated motion pictures of the year. The winner of the 1994 Palme d'Or of the Cannes Film Festival. They should just have someone now just remake the trailers of every movie. Just remake them in a modern way so it's not so corny.
I know, but but that voiceover thing was big. They don't do that anymore.
Because it's corny.
I know, but that was a thing then, dude. This is a long time ago.
Come on, let's get in the character.
I'm so interested in Big Man's wife.
Well, he's going out of town in Florida, and he asked me if I take care of her while he's gone.
Take care?
No, man. Just make sure it's a good time, make sure she don't get lonely.
Girl. You see, this is a moral test of oneself.
I do believe Marcellus, my husband, your boss, told you to take me out and do whatever I wanted.
I love you so much, can't count on
whether or not you can maintain loyalty.
Night of the fight, you may feel a slight sting. Pride only hurts. It never helps. In the fifth, your ass goes down.
I have to say, play with matches, you get burned.
We should have shot guys with this kind of deal.
We're in a lot of danger, aren't we?
I'm prepared to scour the earth for that night.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I break your concentration?
Get down, get down.
You got a corpse in a car, minus a head in a garage. Take me to it.
Don't you hate that? Uncomfortable silences.
John Travolta, Samuel L. Jackson, Uma Thurman, Harvey Keitel, Tim Roth, Amanda Plummer, Maria de Medeiros, Bing Rames, Eric Stoltz, Rosanna Arquette, Christopher Walken, and Bruce Willis.
Looking something for me. Ain't my friend looking.
Die, you mother!
A new film directed by Quentin Tarantino. Pulp Fiction.
You really thinking about quitting?
Most definitely.
What you gonna do then?
Basically, I'm just gonna walk the earth.
What you mean, walk the earth?
You know, like Kane in Kung Fu.
Uh,
I'm not even gonna say anything. It's top of S right now. I'm not.
Not even a fucking hesitation.
No, that's one of the best movies.
Forget about gangster movies. It's one of the fucking greatest films ever made. Forget about gangster.
It's one of the best movies ever.
Forget gangster. Kidding me? It's one of the best films ever made.
I highly recommend it. If you somehow haven't seen Pulp Fiction, honestly, leave the stream and go watch it. This is like, I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that. But yeah, Pulp Fiction is S, top of S right now. That's it. I don't know.
Amazing. Yeah. So much fun. Just fun and crazy and everything else. All right. So this next one is a Martin Scorsese movie called The Gangs in New York. It's set like before the turn of the century. And it's just a very, very interesting movie, historical movie.
And Leonardo DiCaprio's in it.
Leonardo DiCaprio's in it. And I happen to love this movie.
Winner two 2002 Golden Globe Awards. And nominated for 10 Academy Awards, including Best Picture.
Incredible. Absolutely incredible.
On my challenge,
look at this. Fucking epic.
We have met at this chosen ground to settle for good and all. Who holds sway over the Five Points? Us natives or the foreign hordes?
That struck him down. Let me put to rest.
Who are you?
You're the priest's son, aren't you?
His name's Amsterdam.
Amsterdam? I'm New York.
Everything you see belongs to me. The newsboys and quick thieves and blind tigers here in paradise. Everybody owes, everybody pays.
What do you think you're doing?
I'm dancing.
So why aren't you dancing with him?
I'm not in love with him.
There's more of us coming off these ships every day. 15,000 Irish a week. Get all of us together and we ain't got a gang. We got an army.
Challenge.
Challenge accepted.
I took the father. Now I'll take the son.
I give you my word. This will all be finished tomorrow.
No, it won't.
My initial thought, it's under Black Mass.
All right, so Daniel Day-Lewis was tremendous, and he's one of the greatest actors to ever do it.
Mm-hmm.
Leonardo DiCaprio was excellent in this. I'm gonna be. I mean, I could argue a couple of points. I'm looking at the list in total, and I'm saying I'm okay with a B on this one. I mean, it's a tremendous B though. It's an epic movie.
I'm not putting it
with Casino and Reservoir Dogs and Bronx Tale. I'm not doing it. It's a really good movie.
And someone said, why is this movie part of the list? This literally says Gangs of New York.
Guys, you gotta see this movie. It's incredible, man.
What the hell are you talking about?
It's incredible. It's an incredible movie. First of all, just to watch Daniel Day Lewis, that guy's one of the greatest to ever do it.
Do we need to watch the trailer for this? Number one.
It's just Goodfellas is
like when you say a gangster movie, like that's a lot. I feel like most people will say that and like Godfather.
I could not agree more with you. Goodfellas. See, the unique thing about Goodfellas and then when it came out and when it was talked about making a movie and how they made it and the idea, and it's based on a book, Wise Guy. You know, these are all true. It's a true story. It's the first movie that really talked about the low-level day-to-day guy. Like, not like Godfather and like the big, you know, big family and all the rich... Like, these were guys on the street, like, trying to make money. Yeah. So, by far, not even a question. As you guys know, one Alphonse Pacino is my favorite actor. And I absolutely love the next movie that we're going to be looking at, which is called Carlito's Way.
Let's see what this is.
You have seen this. It was a while ago, but you saw this. I watched this with you. He got off the street.
Who's seen this movie?
Now I am sitting.
Got a good feeling.
As soon as I make my 70.
Forever.
Guys went down.
And nothing happened.
There's just this one thing. I'm out.
Every instant.
I can't change that.
And there's only one rule. You save your...
Go ahead. What do you want
to... So, I love Pacino. I love the movie. A couple of issues with the movie. I'm going to put this as a very high B. I'm not giving it an A. I'm saying very high B. For one thing, his accent kind of annoyed me in the movie. But the movie was good. I'm not going to put it on par with Casino or Bronx Tale. But I'm going to say it's a very high B.
I don't know if I'm being insulting by saying I thought it was a C, but...
So why don't we agree to disagree that it could fall into the category, if for you, let's say a low B. I think it needs to be a B. I think that's fair. We're being fair. We're being very fair.
That's fair. Oh, my God.
Oh.
Oh, my God.
Wait. Stop.
Pause.
I think you and I are in total agreement with this.
The Departed.
Oh. How Nicholson didn't win for this.
When I was your age, they would say we could become cops or criminals. What I'm saying is this. When you're facing a loaded gun, what's the difference?
This is not the regular police. This is a state.
Fuck!
We are an elite unit.
This is who we're after.
Frank Costello.
You won't be paid as a regular cop, but there's a bonus involved.
So what do I do?
You will not ever know the identity of undercover people.
You have anyone in with Costello presently?
Maybe.
Do you know who I am?
Maybe not.
I'm gonna have my associates search you.
That was quick. You think he's dead already?
Get your hands off me!
I think we could work something out.
We are all convinced that Costello has at least one mole inside the Special Investigations Unit.
There are parts of my job I can't talk to you about.
Man, you are trouble.
You don't know the half of it.
You better get organized, quick.
Hey, last time I checked, I tipped you off, and you're not in jail.
Getting the feeling we got a cop in my crew.
Sooner or later, he's gonna find out who I am, and he's gonna kill me.
You just gotta let me do it my way.
If you don't, it won't be me who pays for it.
There is a leak from the inside. It's real, man. Smoke him out.
Lying to me.
There are things you don't want to know about.
What are you waiting for, honestly? I mean, do you want him to chop me up and feed me to the poor? Is that what you guys want?
How's your mother?
She's on her way out.
You all are. Act accordingly.
That's an S. That's.
Can I?
You said Pulp Fiction, one of your favorite movies ever. That's one of my favorite movies ever.
Can I tell you something? I'm gonna say this, and it might shock some people. I like Departed better than Goodfellas. You don't have to move it, but when I watch both movies, I love Goodfellas.
That's shocking to hear from you.
There's something about the Departed. There's so many ways to break this movie down. It's such a perfect movie. I'm a huge fan. I could just sit and watch it.
It's perfect.
Goodfellas, I get a little tired of sometimes. I've seen Goodfellas probably 100 times, and I'm good.
Goodfellas is one of those movies where, like,
it's a little depressing though.
I kind of have to watch the whole
movie. They're both depressing, but I
kind of have to watch the whole
Departed, I could turn it on anyway. Yeah, just you could turn the Departed on. That's when you know you're, and I love the characters. Yeah. And bro, Nicholson was fucking amazing.
Yeah.
Now, I have a friend of mine who hated the movie because he goes, Nicholson's Boston accent was terrible. I go, now you're just nitpicking shit? That's one of my favorite. It's in my top 10. It's in my top 10.
Okay, next one is...
Can I set this up? Because I know more about this than these two. I know you're going to kill that because that was garbage.
No, just go ahead.
This one. Guys, there's two John Gotti movies. And I'm going to kind of take the lead on this one because Los didn't see the one from 1996 because he was a bambino. I've seen this movie multiple times. Armand Asante, who's one of my favorite actors, plays John Gotti. This movie was fan-fucking-tastic. Fantastic. I would recommend it highly. It was an HBO movie. They did an amazing job, and I would highly, highly recommend it. This is John Gotti, 1996, Armand Asante.
HBO Home Video tremendous, presents tremendous. A true life story. The epic saga of the rise and fall of a real-life mafia don.
How long have we been around this thing of ours? This goes on also.
In a film packed with grand performances, Armand Asante is...
500,000. Put all this together.
John Gotti's story began on the streets of Queens, New York. A young man who earned the respect...
I see a future.
...and the fear of his elders. A street tough who made the cold, hard climb through the ranks of the Gambino crime family.
The fellow wants to see you.
A man who would stop at nothing to make it to the top. This is the story of John Gotti.
Wherever I'm at, it's because I am who I am. I'm not going to change who I am. I'm not going to apologize.
You wind up in a cell
because you are who you are.
But life at the top is fleeting in an empire built on murder, greed, and betrayal.
So what kind of information do you have to offer?
I'll give you the whole Cosa Nostra.
He's sitting on top of a $500 million a year criminal enterprise.
I want this guy.
You break the rules in this whole thing of ours. Cracks and crumbles.
And in the end, there's no one to trust.
Ever force were her.
There is no.
This is the true life story of John Gotti.
5-10 years from now, Miss John Gotti.
Gotti, available only.
So I'm just gonna tell you, and I'm gonna be honest here. It's on par with Donnie Brasco. But Armand Asante did such an amazing job. I would never give it an A, but it's definitely a B. And guys, a lot of you were young, but the story of John Gotti, who was the head of the Gambino crime family, and this guy nailed it. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, and I think you and I are in agreement with this, I don't even want to watch this trailer of the next one, because it's embarrassing.
I want to see how long this trailer is.
No, it's embarrassing.
This is one of the worst movies I've ever seen.
Can I say this before you run this thing? The fact that this movie was actually made, this movie actually got released. People sat around and went, yeah, let's show this to people. This is one of them. And again, I'm also basing it on the fact that I saw the other John Gotti movie with Armand Asante that was really, really good. John Travolta, like, I don't even understand, like, who around him was like, this thing is good. It was the worst piece of crap. You know what has a zero on Rotten Tomatoes? Do you want to show them?
That's embarrassing.
Pull it up. Bro, do you understand a zero? Like, what does that even mean?
Why did John Travolta do this?
This was, guys, this was, I would almost tell you, I mean, I don't even want to see the trailer, to be honest with you. This was the worst piece of garbage. It was so embarrassing. I don't even understand it. Dude, it got
a zero means that no one liked it.
It got a zero.
That I became a made man.
Dad, I'm thinking maybe taking your
off. Pauses. You know what really annoyed me too? This really bothered me. They have his wife. There's a scene you're going to see with his wife. They're walking out of the courtroom and they ask her a question. And it was, God forbid, she passed away. His wife in real life, Kelly Preston, God forbid, in real life, she passed away. It's a tragedy, but I'm making a point. One of these things that makes me cringe is when people try to do like a New York, New Jersey accent. Like, it's so fucking cringe when people try to do that and they think that's what it sounds like and it's embarrassing. She says something and she's like, they ask him what he does or whatever, and this is what she does. And you're going to play it in a second. She goes like this. She goes, he provides. I almost fucking died of embarrassment, dude. Play the scene.
Dad, I'm thinking maybe take a year off.
You want to hang out with me?
Do you know what you're doing to this family?
I will build something that nobody can destroy.
Salute.
Paul Castellano was a fish in the desert. I never respected Paul.
You killed the boss's boss.
You will bring down hellfire.
There is no choice.
You'll need the support of all five boroughs. Queens, Brooklyn, Manhattan, Staten Island, the Bronx.
Our job now is to maintain leadership. I nominate John Gotti.
To the new boss!
Let everybody know. Now everybody comes to me.
I'm so proud of you.
You should be running your own crew now.
Mr. Gotti, are you the head of the Gambino crime family?
The head of my family.
Mrs. Gotti, do you know what your husband does for a living?
He provides.
John's getting too much press. That can't go unchecked.
It was meant for you.
We've never been under this kind of scrutiny before.
What were you saying on the tapes?
I said a lot of things that could get a lot of people in trouble.
Dad, say the word, I'll go over a cliff for you.
You swore to me that you would not bring him into that world.
This life of ours is a wonderful life, if you can get away with it.
Johnson has been an informant for the FBI.
It's a grand lie!
Order!
You fight till you can't fight no more. Never back off, ever.
We walk together and we fall together. This is the life.
What a complete embarrassment. I don't know how you could watch this thing and be like, it was the worst piece of crap I've ever seen. It was total embarrassment.
All right, we got another old movie.
1995, one of my favorite directors, Michael Mann. The movie is called Heat. It's the first time Pacino and De Niro were ever in a scene together. It's an incredible movie. It's an incredible movie.
I can feel it.
Ugh. You search for the scent of your prey, and then you hunt them down.
Keeps me sharp.
You want to be making moves on the street? Allow nothing to be in your life that you cannot walk out on in 30 seconds flat if you spot the heat around the corner.
Now, my life's a disaster zone because I spend all my time chasing guys like you around the block.
I do what I do best. I take scores. You do what you do best, trying to stop guys like me.
You've been walking through our life dead.
All I am.
From The Godfather to Scent of a Woman.
What do we got?
From Raging Bull.
Assume they got our phones, assume they got our houses, assume they got us.
Their performances have created a legacy of landmark films.
I want full surveillance. That's 24 hours, round the clock. We never close, open 7 days a week.
Now, for the first time, America's two most electrifying actors collide.
With this guy, there's much you should pass.
The bank is worth the risk. You should take it down.
$12.2 million.
You're up. This crew is good.
It ain't worth the risks you take. Like in Risk versus Reward, baby.
You're fugitive number one with a bullet.
I'm double the worst trouble you ever had.
If I'm mad, I gotta put you away. I won't like it, but I'll tell you, you are going down.
What if you do got me boxed in, and I gotta put you down? Because no matter what, you will not get in my way. I will not hesitate for a second.
Al Pacino, Robert De Niro, Val Kilmer, in a Michael Mann film.
It's such an iconic movie, and the crazy thing is, Michael Mann just put out a novel, Heat 2, put out a sequel and a novel. It's a prequel and a sequel, and it's a book.
Ooh, whoa.
The movie is a tremendous movie, and it's about you know, professional thieves and cops that try to, you know, that work those crews, you know, special unit to try to take them down. There's an element, obviously, because they deal with that, you know, with gangsters. I gotta go. On this one, I gotta go A.
Not only do I want to go A,
I'm not go I'm not going, I can't go S because it's not, when I think of a true gangster movie.
I want to go A, and I also want to move an American Gangster to A. I know we're going back, whatever, whatever.
You know what? You know what?
After seeing like these.
I think we got very excited because we love Denzel. We love American Gangster.
Yeah.
I'm in agreement that it's an A. I know it's controversial. I know some people, but I love American Gangster. But
yeah.
Dude, I think we have to respect the S tier.
It's too, these are like God tier movies. All right, next we have a newer one. The Many Saints of Newark.
Yeah, okay.
Some people didn't like this movie. Some people did like this
let's
movie.
Let's watch it and I'll give you my take.
When I was a kid, guys like me were brought up to follow codes.
Hey, jerk off.
What? Dude, this trailer is so misleading because this is not about Tony.
But I think what they had to do is bring you into that world because, you know, he's a young guy, but it's
no, but I get it. But they wanted to sell tickets. They wanted to get people
okay,
to see
go.
It.
Okay, let's go.
Tonio Soprano.
I wonder if I can talk to you alone for a moment, Miss. On the basis of the Sanford Binet, he's high IQ.
You can't prove it by me. He's got a D plus average.
Well, he doesn't apply himself, but he is smart. The results tell us.
Uncle Dick.
Growing up with the family takes a toll.
Maybe an ambassador to England or France.
You're my nephew.
You might like to gamble.
I want to do whatever I can to help you.
You may be a business man.
My gift to you.
I want to go to college. I can't get caught with shit like this.
Look, you take the speakers, right? At the same time, you say to yourself, this is the last time I'm ever going to steal something. It's that simple.
Let me go talk to him.
He only listens to Dickie.
Gotta do something about Dickie Malasani.
Maybe some of the things you do aren't God's favorite.
You lead by example, we'll make the right decision. This kid's got what it takes.
As far as your nephew goes,
I'm listening.
Stay out of his life.
Someone said they're gonna make a sequel.
What's your gut telling you?
Yeah.
I would actually, yeah, I was going to, let's just go with that. Let's just go with B and leave it alone.
It was good. If they're making a sequel, then I guess we'll see what happens with that. I don't think they're going to make a sequel. That's a C, not going to lie. Dude, I liked it. I don't, like, people hated this.
I enjoyed it too, but it wasn't, it's not.
Is it like, is it just C?
See, I feel like, here's what I
you
feel
You know
like.
What, as a story, it might be C. Think about a story.
Dude, I got to be honest with you. I mean, we're being very critical. And I think we need to be with respect to these. I think we're respecting the tiers, and we're not just being willy nilly with them. I'm saying it's a high C. I'm saying it's a high C.
It's just
because you're not putting it up with Black Mash. You're not putting it with Donnie Brasco.
No.
I'm not putting it there. I'm not putting it there. I know some people that hated it. They no, hated
there's
it.
People who would put a DRF.
I'm not putting it DRF. I'm not being ridiculous. I think that's right. I think we're being very reasonable, and I'm going to say it one more time. Because I'm seeing some people that are just disagreeing with us. I think we're holding a lot of respect with the S tier.
Next up, History of Violence.
Can I talk to you about this movie before we say anything or do anything?
Go ahead. I think I know about this, but go ahead.
I know.
How old is this?
This is from
Has anyone seen the History of Violence? Oh, 2005.
Don't play the trailer. There's two movies by the same director, Cronenberg, I believe is, that's how you say it, Cronenberg. I may be pronouncing it wrong. There's two movies on this list by this director. These are gangster movies. The stories and the characters are fucking amazing. This is an incredible movie. There's another movie on here by the same director called Eastern Promises. An absolutely incredible movie. But this one is really, really interesting. And I think the trailer is going to kind of give away what the idea of the movie is. is. I think it does a pretty good job. But this is a favorite movie of mine. I really do enjoy it. So if you want to jump in, pay attention to this. Pay attention. David Cronenberg, right?
Hey, Mr. Stahl.
Hey, Jared.
It's closing up, fellas.
Know that.
Shut up. Do her.
Tom Stahl is rallying behind him, calling him a hero.
Orders.
You're the big hero.
Really don't like talking about it.
Sure took care of those two bad men.
Sarah! My daughter, where is she?
What's going on, Dad?
They thought they knew me. Thought I was somebody else.
Nothing to worry about, Mrs. Stahl. I've been watching over her.
I don't know what you want, and I don't really care.
You should care about it. It might change your life. But why don't you ask Tom and ask him how come he's so good at killing people?
Tell me the truth.
What are you?
Is that a gangster movie?
Yeah, so here's what the deal is. They show you this guy who lives in the middle of nowhere, mm-hmm. in his little town, and these psychopaths come in to the coffee shop where he works, and they're psychopaths. They're gonna kill the woman, kill everybody. They don't care. You saw what they were gonna do. He leaps into action and kills both of them. Now his face is plastered all over the news. I'm not giving anything away. He's a mob guy from Philly that ratted, and they put him in a witness protection program. Mm-hmm. He's like a mad dog killer for the mob. Picture goes all over the news because of this, and those guys come from Philly to get him.
So what are we saying?
So I'm gonna go out on a limb here and just tell you this is absolutely a B. It's absolutely a B. I'm gonna go as far as to say it's in line with Black Mass and Donnie Brasco. It's that good.
Is that good?
It's that good. I would put it.
This is one of the ones that I didn't see.
I know, but I'm walking you through my thought process. And I would say I love the movie. I would say maybe it's not everybody's cup of tea, but I would give it like a middle B.
That's fine, cause
Oh no. Wait, I gotta mentally prepare here. Wait a second.
I mean, we can go through the formality of watching the trailer.
Is this even I would say just for the you wanna go through the formality? Okay.
So what do you call yourself? Eh? Como se llama?
Antonio Montana. What you call yourself?
Where'd you learn to speak the English, Tony?
In a school. And my father, he was from the United States. Yeah? Just like you, you know. He was a Yankee. He used to take me a lot to the movies, you know. I learned. I watched the guys like Humphrey Bogart, James Cagney. They teach me to talk. I like those guys. I always know one day I'm coming here, United States.
1980, Miami. They called it Little Havana, where the American dream had a price tag, and only one man in a million was hungry enough to pay.
This country, you gotta make the money first. Then when you get the money, you get the power. Then when you get the power, then you get the woman.
Scarface. For one brief moment, the world was his.
If a chick is with, she'd like me.
You must be kidding.
What are you talking about? That's a Cadillac.
How do you know?
The eyes, Chico. They never lie.
Man, that's the boss's lady, okay?
I am the boss. That guy's soft. I like you, Tony. There is no lying in you. Here's to the land of opportunity.
We do business together a long time.
I know the street, and I'm making all of my connections.
Remember I told you when you started, the guys who last in this business, the guys who fly straight.
With the right woman, there's no stopping me. I could go right to the top.
Okay.
The word on the street, Tony, is you're not a small-time punk anymore. Supreme Court says that your privacy can be invaded.
to sweep the house this month?
You're spending a lot of money on this counter surveillance.
We're doing 10 million, 15 million a month. Come on. Now, that's serious money, you know? Your bank boys got to come down a bit.
Who else can you trust? That's why you pay us what you do. You trust us. You're in good hands with us.
Al Pacino is Scarface. He loved the American dream. With a vengeance. Al Pacino, Scarface.
Okay, so before we say anything, I want to share something with you, because you know, I've been around a while. I want you to imagine I'm a sophomore in high school, about four or five of us. The movie had an intermission back then. They stopped the movie. You had an intermission. We went out, you know, you had popcorn, whatever, and then you come back in because they had to change the reels. The movie, there was two parts of the movie because it was because it's over 3 hours. Bro, I'm not gonna exaggerate. When this movie ended, and it ended, it was almost midnight. We walk out of the movie theater. I'm not kidding you. Like, I felt like my life was different. And I proceeded to go back. While this was in the movies, I saw it four more times. Completely obsessed with this movie. You know, when it came out, it didn't do well. You know that, right? When it came out, they made fun of the movie. They made fun of Pacino. They thought it was ridiculous. And then it literally became a classic. I'm telling you, my experience with this movie, I remember walking out of that theater. I'm 15 years old. I walked out of that fucking theater and I went, wow. So without batting an eye or hesitation, it goes.
This is a B.
It goes. It's an S, but it's not better than Goodfellas. I mean,
honestly, not even.
I mean, I can't, listen. It's up there. I can't even argue with you. I'm not arguing with you.
I'm not arguing. This is really tough.
It's an S. I'm not arguing. But I'll tell you right now, it's probably the one movie I've seen the most in my whole life. I've probably seen it. I'm saying hundreds of times. It could even be 1,000. I don't even know.
Jet, he knows every word.
We used to watch it in the movie. I had a crew of guys. We used to watch it every week. We would get together and watch it. Do you understand what I'm telling you?
It literally.
We had a VHS, a tape, and it put the tape in, and we watch it every fucking word, man.
This is an old one. Do we have? Oh my god, this is an old trailer again.
Old trailer. Great movie. Very very enjoyable. Very dark. Great actor. Christopher Walken. What are you gonna say?
He's a free man.
How come you never came to see me?
Who wanted to see you in a cage?
What can we expect from the reformed?
I want to be mayor.
Go someplace where you can stay out of trouble.
But some things.
From here on, nothing goes down unless I'm involved. No blackjack, no dope deals, no nothing.
I've been waiting years for this.
I know what you're up to, White. Forget it. I'm going to make you and your friends disappear long before that.
Are you arresting me?
Frank's Park Avenue attorney can get him out in 10 minutes later.
I feel no remorse.
I've noticed in a lot of these old trailers, they always just show like a quick, like few seconds of like whoever, Al Pacino or him or whoever, just making out with a girl.
Well, because they want to throw the sex in there. So, you know, there's a little hanky panky. You know, there's a little, hey, you guys, you know, they want to show a little hanky panky.
But this is like graphic.
I feel no remorse.
That's like graphic.
I feel no remorse.
That's like weird.
I got a $250,000 contract on anyone.
The cops tried to stop him their way.
I'm not your problem. Just the business.
A lot of good actors in this, too, though.
There's only one way to get
Christopher Walken.
Expected to get away with killing all these people?
Killed anybody that didn't deserve it.
You're gonna have to go with this one. I'm gonna trust you on this one because I probably seen this maybe once.
I'm comfortable with a solid B. It's a really cool movie. A lot of good actors. I'm just thinking. I mean, if you want to split hairs, but I'm saying it's a very solid B.
Next we have Get Shorty. So this is an actual good John Travolta.
Very good John Travolta movie. A very iconic character, Chili Palmer. Can I just start off by telling you, I love this movie.
in a
No, that's true. Trailers really don't do any of these movies justice, especially the old movies.
Town known for fame, wealth, and glamour.
This movie's excellent, man. It's an excellent fucking movie.
One honest man has come to Hollywood.
I could just watch this over and over again. It never gets old.
My name's Chili Palmer.
Chili's a gangster. Ran a club I used to play at for another gangster back in Miami. How is Momo these days anyway?
Dead. So you make movies, huh?
I produce feature motion pictures.
I got an idea for a movie.
Doesn't everybody?
Yesterday you were a loan shark.
Yeah, but I was never that into it.
You think the movie business is any different?
Ray, why don't you take a look at this?
You must bring something heavy to the deal.
I do. Me.
I think you ought to turn around and go back to Miami.
You're a stuntman, huh? You're any good?
I mean, he's got no respect for us.
Oh! That's not bad for a guy his size.
Got a major star interested.
Which star?
Two-time Academy Award nominee, Martin Weir.
He played the mob guy turned snitch in Cyclone.
Yeah, one of his best parts.
No, well, the best part was when he played the crippled gay guy that climbed Mount Whitney.
I guess in your line of work, there's times you have to get kind of rough, huh?
Not really.
Have you spoken with Mr. Palmer since your husband blew up?
Oh, my Leo!
It says here you're getting Martin Weir for the part of Lovejoy. How are you going to do that?
I'm going to take a gun, I'm going to put it to his head, and I'm going to say, sign the papers, Martin, or you're dead. That's it.
I wonder, would that work?
John Travolta.
I think you could be an actor. I know you're acting sometimes, but you don't show.
I thought I was faking.
Gene Hackman.
Yeah, let me help you. Go ahead. Suck harder.
Rene Russo.
Harry's dreaming of a $40 million production. He'll never get off the ground. With a star, he'll never sign, with or without my help.
And Danny DeVito.
Looking at you, I'm having memories of us.
I'm wondering, how did it go wrong? How did it all slip away?
Well, it didn't slip away, Martin. You did when you went off with Nikki at my birthday party.
Unbelievable. Yeah, that was a good party.
Rough business, this movie business.
Don't you puke on my shoes, Harry.
I may have to go back to loan sharking just to take a rest.
Get shoddy.
Yeah, the Feeney's in this. I mean, I know where I land on this. Solid.
You go A?
I gotta go A. At a minimum on this movie, I gotta go. I'm putting it up there. Now listen, I understand it's a comedy.
Look what's in A,
bro.
Look what's in A.
I gotta be a little bit. I'm gonna be honest with you.
Look what's in A. I'm just saying, look what's in there.
I gotta go B.
I like the movie.
No, I gotta go B. I'm going B. All right.
I would never.
This is why. No, this is good that we do this.
I would never put it under B.
I gotta go B.
We'll put it high B. We'll go high B with it.
So I don't even. I don't. I'm gonna be honest with you.
What's even the trailer for The Godfather?
I don't even think we should disrespect it by what. I don't even like the fact that we're gonna watch. I mean, do we watch the trailer?
We have to watch the trailer. Yeah. I say we can maybe we don't have to watch the rest of these, but at least.
Well, I mean, we can. I know where some of these are gonna fall. Generally, it's gonna get a little hard now with some of these other ones because some of these are a little bit more obscure.
This is from 1972. Yeah. So don't expect this trailer to be good.
And it's not very long.
What do you want me to do? What I beg you to do?
Now you come to me and you say, Don Corleone, give me justice. You come into my house and you ask me to murder me.
I ask you for justice?
That is not justice.
They want to get mixed up in the family business? You gotta get up close like this. Bada bing! You blow their brains all over your nice Ivy League suit.
Didn't he die?
R.I.P. R.I.P. Yeah. James Caan.
You give him one message, I want Salazzo. If not, it's all out war. We go to the
back. Some of the other families won't sit still.
They may have me, Salazzo.
Your father would want to hear this. This is business, not personal.
They shot my father. It's business.
Even the shooting of your father was business, not personal.
You know my father. Men are coming here to kill him.
I never wanted this for you. I worked my whole life. I don't apologize to take care of my family. And I refuse to be a fool. Dancing on the string held by all those big shots.
It's not personal. It's strictly business.
So I went to the movies with Jake. The 50th anniversary was in March, and I went to the movies. We saw it in the IMAX. Jake said, Dad, I don't know if I've seen the entire thing all the way through. So I went, okay, you're coming with. Two of us sat there. It was like, I don't even know how to explain it. I don't know how did they clean this movie up. It looked like digitally enhanced. The sound was incredible. I'm not only saying gangster movie, I think this is the greatest film ever made. So I don't even know what else to say. So
I think that now we also watch.
So we're gonna go, guys. We're gonna attack. We're gonna attack all three of the Godfathers all at once right now.
Godfather Part Two, winner of 6 Academy Awards, including Best Picture of the Year, Best Supporting Actor, Robert De Niro, Best Director, Francis Ford Coppola,
dude.
Best Original Dramatic Score, Nino Rota and Carmine Coppola, Best Screenplay adapted from another medium, Francis Ford Coppola.
You know, a lot of people say that Puzo. Two is better than the first one.
Best Art Direction and Set Decoration, Dean Cavallaris and Angelo Graham. Set decoration, George R. Nelson. The Godfather, Part 2. The history of two generations of crime. The drama of absolute power and the men who violate it. The Godfather, Part 2.
What is your name?
Don Vito Corleone and his son, Michael, both had seen the ones they loved most cut down before their eyes. Both had killed as an act of vengeance. Both commanded the most powerful and merciless crime organization in the world.
Is it true that in the year 1950, you devised the murder of the heads of the so-called Five Families?
It's a complete falsehood.
They would take any measures.
I mean, you've won. You want to wipe everybody out?
I don't feel I have to wipe everybody out, Tom. Just my enemies.
Make any arrangement.
Michael, we're bigger than U.S. Steel.
Order any death to protect the empire they controlled. The Godfather and his heir, both were men of ice, and both were targets.
They're still on the property. Please stay inside.
Keep them alive.
We'll try.
Michael, alive!
The Godfather Part 2 is Sicily in 1921 and Nevada in 1958. It is revolution in Havana and rubout in New York. It is manipulation.
It would be like trying to kill the president. There's no way we can get to him.
If anything in this life is certain, if history's taught us anything, it says you can kill anyone.
It is murder and it is betrayal. The Godfather Part 2 is the final chapter in the violent history of the Corleone crime family. It is the motion picture masterpiece of the year.
So let's just comment on 1 and 2 before we do anything else. So clearly these are at a different level, and obviously they're S. I don't really even know what to say anymore.
That's it.
There's really nothing else to be said, bro.
There's nothing else that needs to be said. These movies can't be compared to any other movies.
Just that's it. It's over. The conversation is done. Now it's a matter of just kind of others falling in. I want to say this. I want to just say this, and this maybe will just save us a lot of time and aggravation. So God, I just my level of disappointment.
I think it's more of the disappointment than, like, if it was its own movie, maybe.
The movie itself, if it was just kind of, that story was kind of interesting. But the fact that it's The Godfather Part 3, you know what? I'm actually okay with a D.
Like, it deserves the D.
So the movie itself, it probably should be a C, but just because of the disappointment,
yeah.
In my heart, I gotta go D.
It can't go F because nothing touches this.
No, that's a colossal. That's a colossal embarrassment. This is going to be controversial. I can tell you right now.
I already before watching the trailer, I already know my.
This is going to be. This is going to be controversial.
Next one up, The Irishman.
This is going to be controversial.
Yeah, you said right.
Under the contract, management can only fire a driver on very specific charges. So, do you have a show up late?
No.
Do you have any moving violations?
No.
Do you drink on the job?
No.
You ever hit anybody?
I don't think so.
All right, then. We don't have nothing to worry about.
But now I'm a man.
I want you to meet my cousin, Russell Buffalino.
How are you?
Hi, nice to meet you.
It was like the army. You followed orders. You did the right thing. You got rewarded.
I'm a man.
A friend of ours is having a little trouble. Friend at the top.
Back then, there was nobody in this country who didn't know who Jimmy Hoffa was.
We gotta go! Get the gun out of his hand!
You always charge a guy with a gun. With a knife, you run away. So you charge with a gun, with a knife, you run.
Hiya, Frank. Would you like to be a part of history?
Yes, I would.
Big business and the government are working together, trying to pull us apart. Something's gotta be done.
What else you say? Now's not the time to not say.
We're going at war with these people.
War.
Things have gotten out of hand with our friend.
You gotta sit down, everybody says so.
No, I'm not sitting down. I can't do it.
It's what it is.
What it is.
I know things they don't know I know.
It's gonna happen. Either way, he's going.
You know, I don't care whether you did it or not. That makes no difference to me.
Yeah, I know.
I'm here to defend you, right?
What do you want to know? You want to know if I did it or not?
All right. So let's go ahead and be honest. Let's
you
give
want my thoughts first. Or
I,
your thoughts?
No. I want to hear your thoughts first. Go ahead.
So this movie is like one of the newest movies on this whole list. Filmed amazing. Like the picture, the color, everything looks amazing with the movie. The actual story itself, I would put B for like story. The way it looks, I'd go A. So I'm on like a weird thing. I almost think like so many of these movies, if they're made today with today's technology and whatever, they'd be, you know, they would shit on The Irishman.
So
as far as like a story
so
goes.
Let me start by saying this.
Yeah.
It's Scorsese. You've got fucking hitters in that movie. You've got Pesci, De Niro, and then there's just a whole host of other people. I found the story kind of interesting, and I actually didn't know a lot about the story, so that was kind of cool. What's kind of working against it is the fact that, first of all, I usually don't have a problem with this, but it was very long, and I think
you call a movie long, The Godfather's long, but you didn't say, oh, it was too long.
Well, hold on.
Let
me make my point.
You know,
I thought the actors were too old, and they did that facial shit. There's no way I'm going lower than a B. I can't go lower than a B.
No.
But I can't go. I can't go A. I cannot go A on this.
I can't put it A.
I'm not going A. Just for those reasons that I just said, I cannot go A.
I can't go A. There was moments. There were scenes that I loved.
Yeah.
Like for instance, the scene when he goes to that house. I don't know. I thought that was shot cool. Listen, again though, it's like the technology and how it looked was amazing, but I found myself a little bored, fell asleep the first couple times trying to watch it.
I saw it. Here's what's so funny. This was before a pandemic. This was 2019. I went with Uncle Kevin. There was four of us in the whole theater.
Yeah.
My ass and my legs fell asleep because it's pretty long. And I found the same thing. I drifted a little bit.
I drifted.
During parts. But I can't go lower than a B. I can't.
It's B.
We're going to come up on a list of movies right now that some of you may or may not know them. I know that I know you've seen most of them, but they're older. They're older movies. It's last, and we're gonna talk about that. Now, I think we move along here with these pretty quickly as we finish up the list.
Do we need trailers for all these?
So what I would tell you is this: I almost feel like for example, would it do justice not to watch the trailer? Is that fair? I don't know.
Honestly speaking, I haven't seen Miller's Crossing in this.
Why don't we do this? Wait, time out. Stop. Let's do the two that you haven't seen. Let's do those back to back, and I'm going to give you my take on them. Let's just do those back to back. So Road to Perdition and Miller's Crossing, they're sort of in that same... When you see them, they sort of look the same. Mm-hmm. Let's just knock those out, and I'll give you my take on it. I think I'm going to be pretty accurate. I don't know how many out there of you have seen this movie, but, I mean, this movie's 32 years old, so...
From the makers of Blood Simple and Raising Arizona, a world where nothing is what it seems to be. Leo, is he still the boss?
Day I back down from a fight, Gaspers, welcome to the rackets. This town of my place.
This looks like a 60s movie.
It's set... I think it's set in the 40s.
It's at the table.
Casper, can he muscle in?
I'm sick of taking a strap from you, Leo. And I'm sick of the high hat.
Would he sell out a friend?
You shouldn't be confronting Jenny, Casper. That's what I've been trying to tell you.
I can still trade body blows with any man in this town.
And Verna?
Verna, is she Leo's girl?
What did you tell Leo?
I told him you were...
Has he got it figured?
You dumping Leo for the guy who put a bullet in your brother?
Will he turn the tables?
Don't smart me. I want to watch you squirm. I want to see you sweat a little.
All you got to do to show your friend is give me Bernie Burn Bump.
Tommy, you can't do this. You don't bump guys. It's not right, Tom. I can't do
it. Two of us have faced worse odds.
Never without reason.
I thought you said you didn't care about.
I said we were through. It's not the same thing.
I'm talking about friendship. I'm talking about...
What the hell are these punches, bro?
I'm talking about friendship.
What the hell is this?
I mean,
God damn it, bro.
I said we were through. It's not the same thing.
I'm talking about friendship. I'm talking about... I'm talking about ethics.
Albert Finney, Gabriel Byrne.
Where would you put this?
Sergey Hardin.
What?
Where would you put this?
So I'm this is.
This is a B.
Oh, this it's first of all, it's beautifully shot. The actors are tremendous.
And then what is this other one called?
Road to Perdition. Let's do that one. That's Tom Hanks. That's a very, very good movie. I'm recommending this movie.
You know what I think it is? I think I don't like old ass movies. Like, meaning it was set in an old ass time. Godfather, that's different. But everything else, I don't like watching like 40s and 50s things.
Like, this is a very good movie and Tom Hanks is excellent. I'm telling you that this one, I'm not gonna put this with Miller's Crossing. It was very good. I'm gonna go see on this. It was a very good movie, but when I look at this one and Miller's Crossing, I'm saying Miller's Crossing was kind of a cool story.
Dude, Tom Hanks is a gangster.
Michael, tomorrow I want to protect you now.
Sons are put on this earth, trouble their father. Natural law.
I didn't know James Bond was in this.
Do what you love, not the dream.
Natural law's in it. Yeah, it's a good movie.
Okay, so where are you putting this one?
I'm saying it's a high C. We could go B on it, but I'm not doing that. All right, now this is this gangster epic. James Woods and De Niro.
Yeah.
This is just play the trailer and then I'll give you my take on it.
Oh my god.
What?
1984?
You hear enough just like you did for Bugsy.
Oh, you was better off you stayed in the Bronx.
Word of God, Noodles, you and me together, we can make it come true.
Bro, I've seen this. I've seen this.
It seems
I've seen this.
Very good. I mean, I know
where this is a good ass movie.
Yeah, I'm
setting yourselves up in business.
They forged an empire.
Built Pesci's in it. James Woods, De Niro.
Today they ask us to get rid of Joe. Tomorrow they ask me to get rid of you.
I need you guys today.
He's gonna do this. He's gonna do it with or without you.
What do you think?
So I'm gonna. Okay, here's what I'm gonna say with this. I gotta go. I'm going low A. It's an epic movie. It's really. It's pretty amazing, to be honest with you. It's an epic. And Sergio Leone, he's the guy who did all those spaghetti westerns, like The Good, the Bad, the Ugly. The visual is crazy. The acting is great. I mean, I that's a tremendous movie.
That's an A.
I know a lot of you out there have seen Shot Caller. I know a lot of you have seen Shot Caller. This movie is pretty fucking amazing, okay? It's pretty fucking amazing.
I honestly don't think that baseball constitutes a date night.
But there are dugout club seats on the third base.
It's romantic and they're free.
Right?
Yeah, that's right, partner.
Alright.
I need the light!
Tom.
It's an accident. People don't go away for accidents.
Look, man, I know you're scared. But you need to know this. You'll be with the big boys. So you gotta stand up for yourself. Because once you're marked in there,
move!
It will never end.
I'm not looking for trouble.
The fact is, the only thing that matters is you getting home to your family in one piece. You'll get your hands dirty like the rest of us.
Everything you do in this game has a consequence.
We got your rules and we got the gang's rules. And theirs matter.
Once a dude gets institutionalized, anything is possible.
You're handling the deal for a heavy shipment of guns.
Before you say another word, think of your family in this decision.
Nobody's touching my family.
We talked about gangster movies. I mean, these guys are all gangsters. You know, they're in jail, gets out, whatever, dealing with all gangsters. I have to, because I'm looking right now at all these. I gotta go with a B with Shot Caller. I mean, it's definitely above a C. And when I look at like American Me, Miller's Crossing, Carlito's Way, it's in that vein. So I'm saying I'm liking it for a B. Now I would say it's more of a
C than an A, in my opinion. So, you know, I'm down to go B, but for me, it can go B or C.
Why don't we do this? Why don't we compromise? Why don't we go low B? Why don't we go into lowest B and just leave it like that? Because when I look at where the C is, and that movie is just, you know, it's very sad. It's just really good. It's really good. I'm comfortable with that.
Yeah, you know what? No. I take it back. I don't think it's C.
All right. What do we got left here? Wesley Snipes was very good in this. Just
enough. Wesley Snipes.
We will own this city.
Ice-T. Alan Payne. Chris Rock. Mario Van Peebles. Christopher Williams. Vanessa Williams. Tracy Camilla Johns. And Judd Nelson.
This is Detective Nick Peretti, big crazy jarhead, motorcycle freak, reject cop just like you, Scotty.
On the streets, there's a fine line between wrong and right, between those who enforce the law.
It is a war out there.
And those who break it.
Gone are the days of selling on the street corner, dark alleyways in the back rooms of some bummy-ass bar. We ain't with that no more.
In a city where survival depends on friends.
It's always business, never personal.
On family.
We gotta look out for one another.
On trust, on loyalty, on power.
Am I my brother's keeper? Am I my brother's keeper? Yes, I am!
A family out to run a city are up against cop who know it's street.
This ain't business.
Dude, these voiceovers are so corny, bro.
Well, I understand this, but you gotta understand how old this movie is.
This is big business.
Like, this song this doesn't feel like this movie at all.
A lot of that music was in the movie, so that's why it's a big, it really, like, Tony, I don't know if you know who they are, but that was a big part of this.
I'm just saying, like, these,
there's a lot of, you know, Pookie, that was a famous, that was, what's his name? Chris Rock. That was a famous.
This is the American way.
Famous character. This was again, kind of a, this was a big movie.
I haven't seen it. I haven't seen this in.
I know.
I think I was. I was in eighth grade or something.
I'm thinking again. Now we're looking at. Like I'm again, we're being very we're being really critical here. I'm comfortable with a B on this. I'm not comfortable with A. I'm not going A because I had there were some things I didn't love about the movie. There were certain things, but I'm going with a B. I'm comfortable with a B.
Don't say too many B's.
No, but that's good though. Don't you think that's good?
Yeah, I mean,
I think we have, but that's a good thing that we have a lot of B's. It's a good thing. What is wrong with that? There's nothing wrong with it.
Eastern Promises.
Okay, this one, let me give a little background on this one. This was Eastern Promises. It's Russian mafia and it's in England. Viggo Mortensen, which is the same guy who was in History of Violence, and it's the same director, this guy Cronenberg. This is an absolutely fantastic movie. I mean, it's fantastic and, you know, pretty dark, but just an absolutely amazing movie. And Viggo Mortensen does an absolutely incredible job. So just to give you a general idea, he's an undercover cop and he infiltrates the Russian mafia in England. They're in England.
We think he might be Russian mafia.
And he was a member of Vorev Sokolnia.
In Russian prisons, your life story is written on your body. And tattoos.
If you don't have tattoos, you don't exist.
I'm afraid we've lost the mother.
Unidentified woman died December the 20th, 2313. Baby girl born 20th of December, 2314.
Anya, where did you get this?
I found it in the handbag of a girl who died in my ward.
You should bury her secrets with her body.
I'm a midwife. I was hoping to speak to the manager.
And I'm so sorry if she had worked here. I would remember it is said.
I'll probably find out more once I get her diary translated.
A diary?
You want to go for a drink?
It's Christmas. Everything's closed.
Sometimes, if things are closed, you just open them up.
This girl ended up in the hands of the Voriva Sokolnyi. Do you know what that means?
How did you get in here?
They are always open doors.
He wants the diary.
My son Kirill's. Mentioned many a times.
I think he was threatening to harm the baby.
If the diary should find its way to the police.
Okay, boss, you don't have to worry. Police won't find anything.
She was 14, just a child.
Forget any of this ever happened. Stay away from people like me.
Have you read the diary? How can you keep doing what you're doing?
I decide what's right and what's wrong. You can't afford to be killers in any area.
I need to know who you are.
Show some respect.
This is respect.
The Vori were like a contagious disease. There's no cure once they've touched you.
So let me just give you a little background on this. So I'm gonna tell you something right now. I'm not gonna say it. Eastern Promises, that movie is an A.
That's an A.
It's absolutely an A. The story. You keep seeing I forgot her name. The actress. The point of this is, remember when she showed the baby? Well, these guys are gangsters. They have, you know, they have prostitutes and drugs. They do everything. It was a girl that was killed, and she had a baby. I'm not gonna tell you what happened because that would ruin the story. Who they find out, a father of the baby. That's a big part of this. And they're all these Russian mob guys, and they're brutal. They're totally brutal. That movie, Eastern Promises, is tremendous. If you guys haven't seen this movie, it's absolutely fantastic. All right, now I have a question. How many of you guys have seen this Guy Ritchie movie, Rock and Roller? This movie's absolutely it's British gangsters. The characters are fucking totally outrageous. It's just a fantastic movie.
Yeah, I like how this movie was filmed.
It's fucking great, dude. Fantastic.
You're it. You are the only one. You are so
take care of them. What do you think we are, gangsters?
So I love Guy Ritchie. We could have probably put another couple of his movies on here, but we had to make a decision. Just taking a look at who's in B.
I would put it under Irish.
Okay, I'm okay with that. Now I want to say this. The year is 19. Don't play it yet. The year is 1987. I'm down at the shore. Aunt Jackie comes over and she says, "Hey, I saw this movie last night, and there's this Italian guy in it, and he looks like you." Okay, I go, What's the name of the movie? She goes, "The Untouchable." She goes, "Oh, it's about Elliot Ness, you know, the FBI guy, and he's going after Al Capone." This movie, I'm going to tell you right now, this movie's absolutely fucking fantastic.
This is a true story or no?
It's based on a true story, how Elliot Ness finally got Al Capone.
"I grew up in a tough neighborhood.
This is amazing, dude. Amazing.
Sometimes reputation follows you."
Robert De Niro is
Al Capone. Guys, you've seen this.
There is violence in Chicago, of course, but not by me, not by anybody I employ, and I'll tell you why.
Kevin Costner is Elliot Ness.
"I have sworn to put this man away with any and all legal means at my disposal, and I will do so."
Sean Connery is Jimmy Malone.
"Want to get Capone? Here's how you get him. He pulls a knife, you pull a gun. He sends one of yours to the hospital, you send one of his to the morgue. That's it. The Chicago way."
"Just joined the Treasury Department."
So Aunt Jackie goes, "Yeah, there's this Italian guy in it. And first of all, he's Cuban, but he looks Italian." And I saw, so now a whole bunch of us went to see this. We went to the movie theater. And like, he comes on the screen. They were all like, because nobody knew who he was. They're like, they all looked at me like, "The fuck?" I went, dude, I laughed my ass. Because that's pretty much what I look like when I was, pretty much what I look like.
"Everybody knows where the booze is. The problem isn't finding it.
Let's do some good.
The problem is who wants to cross the pond.
Somebody messes with me, I'm gonna mess with him."
"You carry a badge? Carry a gun."
Love this.
Fucking, "Get your hands in the air!"
Fucking love
"You're
this.
All under arrest."
"You fellas are untouchable.
Is that the thing? No one can get to you?
Hey, everybody can be gotten to."
"All right then. Drive him to the station. Anything happens, you shoot first, you understand me?"
"Well, I'll tell you one more thing. You got an all-out prize fight, you wait till the fight's over, one guy's left standing, and that's how you know who won."
"Just tell me, are you being careful?"
"Careful as mice."
"I want to hurt the man Malone. I want to start taking the battle to him. I want to hurt Capone."
"This man can finger Al Capone. This man can put Capone behind bars."
"Well, what's the matter? Can't you talk with a gun in your mouth?"
"You're not to prove your methods." "Yeah? Well, you're not from Chicago."
"I want you to find this Nancy boy, Elliot Ness. I want him dead. I want his family dead."
Paramount Pictures presents a Brian De Palma film.
"I have forsworn myself. I have broken every law I swore to defend. I have become what I beheld, and I am content that I have done right."
"You got nothing. Nothing. And if you were a man, you would have done it now."
"Never stop fighting till the fight is done."
The Untouchables.
This is the last one. I have to tell you, I'm gonna tell you that this might be a stretch.
Don't say that. Because here's the bottom line. If it was an S, it would have just been automatic.
Well, here's what I'm going with then. I mean, I'm looking at S, but what I am gonna tell you, to me it's a top A. That now I gotta tell you, I'm comfortable with that. Because we have respect. First of all, Godfather's Godfather, but we have respect for that top tier. And Untouchables is a top A. I'm comfortable with that. I think this looks good. And look how everything kind of falls in that.
Everything. I mean, dude, it's just like an average. Like there's more in the average, and then it gets rarer to, you know.
These are great. These are, guys, fucking take a look at this, man. Now, listen, I understand. I saw, and I'll say it again. I saw some of you threw out a couple, two, three, four different movies. I get it. We had to make decisions based on a number of factors. And this is this is what we came up with. I'm damn proud of this list, and I'm damn proud of the tier list. I think it's excellent. I think it's going to be a nice. I think it's a really nice. I think it's good, man.
If we want to make it legit,
I'm looking at this list. I'm telling you right now, I'm super. I mean, maybe one or two could have went a different way, but no, I'm very happy with it, man. I'm very happy.
Even like,
nah, what are we gonna do? Let don't split hairs. Leave it alone. What are we gonna talk about? We're gonna move something from.
No, I'm not gonna move.
I gotta tell you right now. I love. Listen, we obviously are looking at the iconic S tier. Those movies are just iconic. But dude, I'm really happy with the A's. I'm very happy with the A's. Those are real A's. Those are solid A's.
There's some B's that could go A.
You know what? If we just sat down and really analyzed, I gotta tell you right now, I'm looking at this. A B is solid. I mean, to be at the A, you gotta, that's next level. And then forget about S. That's a whole nother, you know where that is. I know. Some of you are going, a Casino should be an S. You and I discussed it. It wasn't a perfect movie. It was not a, I had some.
Like, S tier movies, nothing annoys you. Nothing is wrong. There's things that are annoying in some A movies. B movies, definitely. C, 100%.
Some things at Casino I would have done a little different. I'm going to be honest with you. I would have done a little different. When you look at S, I'm not touching. I'm not doing anything. I'm not touching it. I'm not even doing anything with it. It's fantastic. I'm so happy we were able to do this finally.